Yoi, this is Taylor Umongus Has here, and I'll be showing off my new Minecraft mod, which I made using Minecraft Forge 1.16.4. Now, let's take a look at the mod. It's called Umongus' Surival in the Wild, which is just like the title says, surviving in the wild. Now, as this description says, a few extra tools, guns, and dangerous animals to make your Minecraft survival experience more exciting. This mod includes knives, machetes, spears, old-fashioned guns, snakes, boars, crocodiles, and more. Seems exciting, isn't it? Even though it might be kind of basic compared to most mods. Usually the new tools I've added were combat tools. Well, anyways, let's create a new world. Survival. Umongus mod. World options. Let's put the bonus chest on. And, game rules. And normal difficulty, and create new world. So we have created a new world. Now I'm going to start by showing off some... Whoa, there's some bulls right there. We're going to get as far away as possible. The thing about this mod is that the dangerous animals in this game have a really far following distance. So no matter how far you run, they might always be coming after you. And also they run really fast. But hopefully they won't be kept... be able to get past all these trees, because these animals have kind of a large hitbox, so it might be hard for them to move around when there are so many trees. Now that I'm kind of far away from the spawn point, it might be kind of hard to find where my house is and have to travel kind of a large distance. But hey, on the bright side, there's a cave right here. A canyon would be a good place for mining things. Alright, now I've made it here, and well, the bulls still aren't chasing me. So anyways, here's how to make a wooden machete. So the machetes are just like swords, but they take more material to make and have a higher attack speed. Same attack damage though. And now here's the wooden knife. 2 attack damage, and while they have fast attack speed, it also means knives run out of durability faster, which makes up for its taking less material. And this is how you craft a wooden knife. Now, here's to a wooden spear. 6 attack damage, 1 attack speed. Now I'm going to show you the comparisons with other material types later. But as of now, we'll have to wait until we get some stone. But after I create this chest and store some items in here, I'm going to use this wooden spear and see what we can do about those bulls over there. And if we can get to our bonus chest. If I can find it. Whoa. Actually, my only goal right now is to try to get to the bonus chest without attracting the attention of the bulls. Which eventually I might rename them to buffaloes, since bulls aren't. Whoa. It stuck there. Anyways, its hitbox is actually kind of weird, so it's actually kind of hard fighting them. Whoa! they have 25 hearts of health. So I guess they've just now found a good tactic. Oh no, there's another one. Oh! Yeah, these guys spawn in groups of 1 to 2. guess they're kind of based off of the king buffalo, which is one of the most dangerous animals in the world. And yet its appearance looks similar. I found the bonus chest, though. Whoa. Oh, there's no escape. These scary creatures. And yeah, so they have a similar appearance to a bison, it seems. Fortunately, since all creatures have pretty much the same swim speed, being in the water is a good tactic to escape from them. We are going to have to get rid of this bowl. If it was in open land, and if you don't have a shield, it will be practically impossible to fight against these guys. Whoa. Whoa. Oh. Are we gonna have to respawn a bunch of times? It seems so. Oh no, it's coming after me. Run. Oh wow, this bonus chest is giving me good items. Stone gear. Okay, well, where's that bowl? Fortunately, its footsteps are loud and noticeable. Now the bowls make ravager noises. I've got to find my house. If the bull doesn't find me first. Ooh. Ooh, a canyon. Or cave. If I remember correctly, my house would be close to some taiga biomes. Looks like it'd be that way. But yeah, these bulls though, they run so fast that you just can't even escape them when you're sprinting. That's how fast they are. And they're probably the most dangerous animal in this mod, except maybe the elephant, which although runs slower, it has more health and attack damage. Right guys, now we didn't exactly find my house, we found some snakes, and they make spider noises. Yeah, fortunately the snakes in this mod aren't venomous, because I don't know how to make them venomous yet. And they're the least dangerous enemies in the game, at least as far as one-on-one, but they spawn in large groups so they can swarm you. And look, they're still chasing me. So they have 2.5 hearts of health. Oh, and there are some wild boars over there. They have 10 hearts of health, just like the player. Now, wild boars, on the other hand, they're not so hard to fight against. No, not like the bulls and elephants. But yeah, here are all the animals in the game. They have snakes, crocodiles, wild boar, bulls, and elephants. Oh, and if you hear a zombie noise, that might be a crocodile. Or maybe it's an actual zombie. Oh, finally found. on my house. Oh, I had no idea it was this close to the wild boars. The wild boars have a shorter follow distance than bulls and elephants, but oh, I think they actually notice me. Oh, we're gonna need. Yeah, it is following me. Yeah, I need my old items, but there's a bowl where I died last time. Yeah, I gotta beware for these berry bushes. They have thorns just like cactuses. Now, if I can just find the place where I died to a bowl. I should probably take care of these wild boars first. Whoa. Yeah, these wild boars make zoglin noises. Whoa. I guess hiding in the water is a good strategy against these guys. Now, the crocodiles in this game spawn in rivers and swamps, whereas pretty much every other creature in this mod can spawn pretty much anywhere. Anyways, it's nighttime now, and I found that bowl again. Oh. Which means that my items are probably that way. If I can... Traps are a good way to deal with a lot of creatures. Oh. So now, hopefully we can find my item somewhere. Unless that was a completely different bowl. Oh, here's the bonus chest. Hopefully no more dangerous animals around here. The bad news though is looks like we've lost our items. Because they've expired. It took too long to find my house. So, I'm gonna have to make my house highly visible somehow. Well, right now I'm gonna go mining, and I'll be back after I'm able to make some stone tools. Now, in case any of you wanted to see a comparison between different tools, well, let's compare a knife and. Well, we don't have any more spears. Any more wooden spears. But, here, the recipe for wooden spear again. Yoi. And now, we'll make a stone knife. A stone machete. And, stone spear. Now, as a comparison, well, here's the wooden knife, 2 attack damage, 2.5 attack speed. The stone knife, 3 attack damage, 3 attack speed. So yeah, increase in damage each time, and also increase in attack speed. Now here's the wooden machete, and stone machete. Now, you know the drill, the machete's just a faster version of the sword. And then here's the wooden spear, 6 attack damage, 1 attack speed. Stone spear, 8 attack damage and 0.8 attack speed. So with spears, the higher tier equals 2 more attack damage, but it also means lower attack speed. So anyways, we're gonna put all these things away. And I'm gonna go back underground to do some more mining, and I'll come back with some kind of update. Hey guys, I'm back, and it's night time, and I feel like taking on some monsters, or a wooden spear. Let's actually drain my wooden tools first, before we start using the stone ones. Anyways, let's see if we can find either, creeper. A good thing that shields were put into the game. Whoa, all of those creatures down there. Not that I'd ever go down there though, because then I'd never be able to get back up. A lot of zombies. Oh, here comes a skeleton and another zombie. Well, I've ran out of weapons. Gotta go get my stone gear. My stone machete and my stone spear. If I can find my house. There it is. I would have never found my house if it was daytime, where the torches aren't visible. Hopefully that creeper's not still coming after me. Oh, there's the creep. Yeah, the zombies have definitely become more dangerous now. I remember back when if you had a stone sword, you can pretty much fight off an entire crowd of zombies. And excuse the train there. Well, not in Minecraft, but the sound you heard. So yeah, the stone spear is a pretty good weapon to use, and especially against spiders, which it would only take 2 stone spear hits. Oh, skeleton versus skeleton. Oh, where'd it go? That's a lot of skeletons. skeletons are there? Between skeletons. Wow. That was way easier than it should have been. Well, now I've got a lot of bones and arrows. Guys, there was a lot of sand blocks right here, and then I destroyed one and all the sand fell down. And now water is flooding the place. Oh. Zombie noises. An elephant. So I lost my house. So then I started trying to look for it. And then I heard some footsteps, so then I started recording again. And then there was that elephant. On the bright side, finally found my house again. Yeah. Oh, good thing I didn't lose anything too valuable. Alright guys, so I've made it to the Nether, and wow, there are all these tall trees. Yeah, the Nether's nowhere near like it used to be. And you get that glowing stuff up there. Let's see what it is. This mod doesn't add any extra animals into the Nether though. They stopped attacking. These creatures creatures have a weird behavior. Find my nether portal. Whoa. And piglins. Yeah, my nether portal's over there. Intense. So they gave us pork chop meat and leather, wart fungus, weeping vines, crimson roots. So I guess there's a new type of tree called the crimson tree and it's in the nether. Yeah, I don't really know what's worse, the hoglins in the nether or the wild boars in this mod. Well guys, now I have the ingredients to craft a pistol in this mod. Now there are three types of guns in this game. There's the pistol, the shotgun, and the rifle. But this is all we have for now. And now this definitely won't work until we craft some ammunition. But to do that, we'll need some flint and some TNT. Which, I can make some TNT, but it'll be a while before I get enough flint. Alright, now we have ran into some snakes. I was actually pretty far away from my house though, because I was digging underground and got lost inside a cave, so then I dug my way back up and seemed to appear somewhere far away. But yeah, those are the snakes for you. Anyways guys, that'll be it as of now. If you're wondering more stuff, stay tuned for part 2 of this mod version, where you will see ammunition being crafted and then the guns in the game actually being used. Now at this point I've gotten 4 diamonds and obsidian, and I have another portal, and I'm about to build an enchanting table, and see you next time.